Welcome to the first modern video I'm recording here post Pro Tour on channelfireball.com. So, of course, I'm playing the Eldrazi deck. Why would I not be playing Eldrazi? Eldrazi are great. They're gigantic, they're monstrous, and they come out for way cheaper than they should. So, this is a Bant Eldrazi deck that I'm kind of trying out here. Basically, you've got the core of Eldrazi, which is to say Thought Not Seer, Reality Smasher, Eldrazi Mimic, Endless One, Dismember, which I actually do include here because I think Dismember is amazing right now. And then 4 Eldrazi Temple, 4 Iavugan. Alongside those, I'm trying out a couple things. First of all, I'm trying out Drowner of Hope, which won the Pro Tour, defeated me on the way, unfortunately, and is a very good card. I think Drowner of Hope is good enough that it's worth playing blue. You also get Eldrazi Sky Spawner, which is not as good as Drowner, but still, I think, a modern playable, which is kind of funny. There's also two copies of Worldbreaker. I like Worldbreaker because a lot of the cards people are leaning on to beat Eldrazi, Warship, Ensnaring Bridge, that sort of thing, well, they get broken by this, and in the mirror, it's also very relevant because it helps you win the Iavugan fights. The last card and the most unique card here is Eldrazi Displacer. I think Eldrazi Displacer has the ability to be very good. First of all, it's a 3-3 Eldrazi for 3, which means, and it costs 2 generic mana, so often it'll come out for 1 mana, which, that's already a pretty big benefit. And then the ability of exiling a creature then returning it to the battlefield tapped does a couple things. First of all, you can flicker Drowners and keep getting 2 tokens. Sky Spawner and get 1, which isn't the most impressive, but Drowner getting 2 is nice. Unfortunately, it doesn't work with the Worldbreaker, because that's on cast. You can flicker other colorless creatures that you control and keep resetting the Mimic's power to greater, if you need to. You can flicker Thought Not Seer, so the opponent will draw a card, but then Thought Not Seer will come back and then exile. So, on average, this ought to be pretty good. Every time they get lands, you don't end up exiling anything, but you can keep flickering Thought Not to take cards out of their hand. And then it can save all your creatures from removal. It can also kill opposing Endless Ones. I would not recommend flickering your own. And overall, it's a pretty interesting card, so I want to try it out. The mana base is a little different than before, so it's got the 8, you know, Ancient Tombs, double lands. It's also got 4 Cavern of Souls and 2 Corrupted Crossroads, which are very similar, though Cavern of Souls is just better. They let you cast all your Eldrazi because they tap for colorless, or they tap for white or blue for these guys, and then green for Worldbreaker. 4 copies of Darkar Wastes, which can cast your, you know, 8 blue cards or 4 white cards, plus provide colorless, and then a slight actual land mana base of 1 Hallowed Fountain, 1 Breeding Pool, 2 Flooded Strands, then 1 Island, 1 Plains. I think you want 2 basics in the deck. I liked having 2 basics at the Pro Tour. The eventual winner also had 2 basics, JZ Tau, and I think there's enough colorless sources that you can afford to get away with Island and Plains. And then Flooded Strand means that you've got a bunch of sources for white and blue that also can get your Breeding Pool so you can cast Worldbreaker. You've got 7 sources plus the 2 Flooded Strands, so 9 sources for Worldbreaker in your deck, which you don't need until later, so I think that's reasonable. Sideboard is kind of a mashup of colorless cards and not colorless cards. Just only 1 copy of Gutshot because I've got 2 Hercules Recalls and 2 Stony Silence. Again, I like these cards, first of all, against Affinity, which is one of your tougher matchups, and you have enough colored sources that you can actually play these really powerful anti-Affinity cards, no more Ratchet Bombs. And because when you're playing against a deck like, say, Lantern, Stony Silence, Hercules Recall actually has utility there as well. I've also got 2 copies of Vesuva for the mirror, because you can piggyback off of their 2 mana lands. You don't have to mulligan as aggressively when you've got essentially 10 copies of these lands, because even if you don't have an Eye or Temple in your opening hand, your opponent probably will, and you can play Vesuva to copy them. Also, a Ghost Quarter as just an additional piece of disruption for the mirror and against Affinity. 4 Relics. I was impressed with these. They not only shut off Living End, or at least fight it, and Living End's one of your tougher matchups, it's also good with Oblivion Sower, another card which I really like in the mirror and against control decks or decks like Obzon. Plus, Relic deals with Tarmogoyf, which is an important characteristic as well. Alright, I'm in a league. Let's get to it. Alrighty, I'm on the draw, and, well, yes, I'm going to keep this hand. It's great. It's got turn 2 Sky Spawner, turn 3 Thought Knot, turn 4 Reality Smasher, or another Thought Knot, depending on what I'm playing against. Blink Moth Nexus. Affinity is my guess. Yes, indeed. Alright. Well, Eldrazi Sky Spawner is good against Affinity. So here, it's actually kind of a close call. So I want to play Hallowed Fountain because I'll take less damage that way. I think that's fine. The reason I'm doing that is because even though if I draw Iavugan or Eldrazi Temple, I will have wished I played Temple first. I think the fact that Sky Spawner is still a pretty good turn 2 play, and these games are so close that taking an extra 2 damage off Hallowed Fountain just does not seem like a very good idea. If I was on the play, I think I would have won this game easily. Welcome to Modern. Well, depends what my opponent has here. Probably going to draw Eldrazi Temple because I'm very unlucky. Well, there we go. Punished. It's alright. I can play Sky Spawn Air, and that does keep Cranial Plating off my back and makes that Ravager a little bit worse here. Let's see what my opponent is up to. Master of Ethereum would be the biggest problem if my opponent has one of those. Steel Overseer, well, actually also could be a huge problem. So, well, I guess if my opponent has all these things, maybe I would have lost even if I played a turn two Thought Knots here. I need to draw Dismember, did not. If all these great Eldrazi to play, and if I had an Eye of Ugin, then we'd be talking, because then I could play Thought Knot plus Sky Spawner or double Thought Knot here. Unfortunately, I'm going to get to play, like, one thing. I mean, I suppose I could play Sky Spawner into Thought Knot here, but then I'd give up two Eldrazi Scions. I don't really love that idea. Oh, man, I'm just going to lose really badly to that Reality Smasher, or not Reality Smasher, to that Steel Overseer. Yeah, I think I'm just dead. I mean, I'm going to go ahead and play a Thought Knot here, but I really cannot imagine beating Steel Overseer in this particular spot in a Cranial Plating. Just the fact that my opponent's getting, if they activate their Nexus now and now they have Ornithopter, they're getting 7 plus 1 counters every time they tap Steel Overseer, makes it hard to imagine what my path to victory is here. Suppose I could draw Dismember? Maybe? I don't know. Alright, so they're all coming in. I guess I'll block the Vault Scourge and force my opponent to do something here. Which likely means sacking a Ravager to the other Ravager, putting two counters on Vault Scourge. And alright, well, I guess if I draw Dismember this turn, I still probably have lost, but at least it could be interesting. Wow, another Thought Knots here, or another Eldrazi Temple, so 16, yeah, I'm just dead here. Brutal. Affinity's a good deck. Had I played Thought Knot turn 2, taken Steel Overseer, yeah, I might have won, actually. Well, let's put in those cards, and Ghost Quarter, take out Worldbreaker because it's slow. And Matter Reshaper comes out, and I actually don't really like Eldrazi Mimic all that much here. Just because Eldrazi Displacer might be worse, but Displacer seems like it's got some interesting stuff going on, so I'm going to try it. Alright, well, I would like to play first. Yeah, this hand is acceptable. It's got turn 1 Mimic, turn 2 Eldrazi Displacer, turn 3 Thought Knot Seer with Hercule's Recall backup. Ooh, Hercule's Recall, Thought Knot Seer. In a turn, Hercule's Recall, you untap, play Thought Knot Seer, take your best card. Broken. And my opponent doesn't have a 1-drop. Interesting. Alright, well, I guess I'll allow it. Let's get the Hallowed Fountain here. Pay 2 life, play Eldrazi Displacer. I suppose I need to draw land here. If I draw a land, which I even sided one extra in because of the Ghost Quarter, if I draw a land here, then I'm in really good shape. Unfortunately, I've got a lot of cards I could draw that I can't cast. Like if I draw another Reality Smasher or something along those lines, that would not be great. Or a Drowner of Hope. Alright, Steel Overseer doesn't bother me quite as much. Well, Sky Spawner at least means next turn I'll be able to cast Thought Knot Seer. And yeah, I'll make it a 2-1. Let's not make it a 1-1. I guess I could make it a 1-1, then make it a 2-1. But either way. Offer the trade here. My opponent's not going to accept, of course. Next turn, I'm going to play Thought Knot, and then the turn after that, I'm going to cast Hercule's Recall. At least that's my plan. But I did draw Memnite, which is a good draw. Master of Ethereum. Alright. I could also potentially Hercule. So if I Hercule's this turn, then I attack my opponent for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. Put my opponent down to 4. Actually, that sounds even better. Why don't I just do that? Especially since it'll kill my opponent's Glimmer Void. Oh yeah. Never mind. That's great. So, and then my opponent's going to be able to recast not nearly enough blockers. So it turns out all these expensive Eldrazi never hit the table, but that's alright. Yeah, I don't see how my opponent can win there. Alright, well, close game. On the draw, do I want to change anything? It's possible. No, you know, Drowner actually seems really good. It by itself shuts down a lot of your opponent's attacks. I guess I could take out a Displacer for a Matter Reshaper on the draw, because I'm a little more likely, and maybe just put in another Mimic. No, Mimics are just bad, too. Maybe I just take out all the Mimics and just put in all the, have all the three drops in. Yeah, that sounds a little bit better. All right, no two mana land, but a turn two Stony Silence. Don't know if that's actually going to be good enough on the draw. It really depends on the texture of my opponent's draw. Well, if it's turn one Nexus, then I'm actually feeling pretty good about it. All right, let's play Breeding Pool. I think I can do better than playing a endless one for one here. Eldrazi Temple would have been a nice draw. So now my opponent's going to play like a Ravager or something or a Steel Overseer. Wow, one gut shot, and I would just wreck my opponent here. Actually, I might just dismember my opponent's Ravager here. If I do that, my opponent loses Glimmer Void? Yeah, that. And, like, what's their play next turn? My opponent's hands have not been great. I will admit that. All right, let's play that because I'm going to be able to use it next turn to play Stony Silence. Well, didn't really need my sideboard cards to beat this, I don't think. Like, if I draw two mana land, I'm just playing a Thought Knot. Well, I guess not. Alright, let's play Eldrazi, and I'm just going to play Stony Silence here. There's no reason to get greedy. Might as well lock my opponent out of casting. Well, not casting most things, because they only have one land, and it taps for mana anyway, but now they can't like play Springleaf Drum or Mox Opal for any effect. Alright, well, no lands, but that's alright. Let's just play. I wouldn't say it's an endless one. The end is in sight. It's just a 3-3, but if I draw any land, I can play Thought Knot Seer. I'm getting attacked for one here. I've got to be able to outrace this. And if I draw a two-mana land, I probably just play the Reality Smasher. I don't think my opponent's got too many good cards. Actually, Signal Pest is very good there. Wow, am I actually just going to lose to this bunch of Signal Pests? I guess if I can't cast anything. I don't really want to dismember here. That's not double click. Alright, so now I'm getting attacked for four. I should still be able to win this race, though. I guess if my opponent draws land, they can activate Nexus and hit me for three more damage. If I draw land, then I can win the race somewhat easily, though. Because then I get to play Thought Knot or Reality Smasher. Ideally, I draw two mana land here. Alright, there we go. Let's play Reality Smasher. I just don't think my opponent's that likely to have something that I care about taking with Thought Knot. I'd rather just hit my opponent for 11 here and make it so they likely cannot win. Honestly, don't even know how good Stony Silence was here. I guess had I not had Stony Silence in play, my opponent would have cast Springleaf Drum earlier. They may have a Mox Opal in their hand as well. Though they would have played it with the Glimmer Void in play, I would hope. Now they're at 6, so yeah, they're in chump block mode. All right. Got match one against Affinity, partially thanks to sideboard cards, partially thanks to the opening of Glimmer Void Ravager, which did not work out well for my opponent.